friend. He's having a great time. Ain't got no more mates, Oz.
Sorry, buddy.
Those little ones, little turds. Stop stealing the big one's food. Goodbye, buddy.
It would appear that the garden has frozen over. Does that mean...
Yeah, boy! No!
There we go. Big piece. Yeah. Ha! Yes!
And here you'll find all of the students gathering by the waterhole. Forced out of their natural habitats by a fire!
Oh, I meant to tell you, we got our results back from the exam. I did as expected. There are some... He's slowly getting lower down. there are some areas that I need to work on, as I thought there'd be. But apart from that, it's fine. There was something that I was actually going to say to you. I wasn't just going to blather. There was something I was going to say. What was it?
Well, whatever it was, it's gone. So that's great. But there was, it's annoying. There was something that we've got news days tomorrow, which is alright. It's alright. News week wasn't as bad, so news days aren't gonna be that bad. I don't know, don't judge me.
So we've got Valentine's Day coming up. This is what I was gonna say. We got Valentine's Day coming up. And I've got a whole bunch of mixed feelings about Valentine's Day. Like, I complain about it a lot, and I just complain about it a lot. But I do actually kind of like it. I mean, it sucks being single on Valentine's Day, because it definitely feels like you're the only one who is single on Valentine's Day. But it's a really nice concept. It's a really nice idea. And though I am incredibly bitter and salty about the fact that I am V-lonely, I don't know, the overall aesthetic and idea of Valentine's Day is, it's nice. And the day that I get over my bitterness and saltiness is the day that I will fully enjoy it to the max. But I'm probably going to, on the 14th of February, which is Tuesday. So I'm going to go to uni, come home, eat ice cream, watch rom-coms and cry. Because I will never have a life like Amanda Seyfried. Oh look, we're back outside. Sam, how do you feel about the second fire alarm?
I feel bloody cold.
He lost his appeal because he hadn't provided enough evidence to justify refusing entry to people from 7 countries.
We are turning Sam into Lisa. Oh no, Lisa, what happened? And a Brummie accent.
She's so excited.
So hang on, are you guys face swapping? Lisa, please put this on your story. Oh, hey, hi. Didn't see you there. How's it going? Is it going good? Is it all right?
Yes, it's a fat one. This is a fat lip liner. You have caught me at a very... What's the word? I always do this. I always start talking and I'm like, what's the word I'm looking for? Tell me what it is. I just went on like a self-care spree and now I'm really hyper. Don't ask me why. I've not ingested anything. Ingest. I've not eaten anything a bit weird or anything. I think it's the smell of my Lush product because I'm gone with the wind. And what was I gonna say? I just completely forgot what I was gonna say. Wow, I had a point, and now my brain is just like, la la, too hyper, not gonna let you talk now. Okay, is that sharp enough? I don't know. I hope so. In case anyone's wondering, which I don't think you are, I have, lost my breath now. Oh God, I have the Helen E. lip liner. Hashtag beauty guru. Yeah, and the Gwen Stefani spiderweb range from Urban Decay. I love Urban Decay. Love Urban Decay. I think I might get a darker one, a darker red, when this goes. Because, like, this is great. But one, they've discontinued it. Lol, just my luck. Yeah, they've discontinued it. But also, it's bright. It's very bright. Or it could be a mixture of both this and the lip liner. I don't know. I think I might see if Helen E do a darker version to that red. Because I think I need one. Like, I've got pale skin and dark hair, you know. I need, like, blood. I need blood-red lips. I also need a better compact mirror as well, because this is, like, plain AF. I saw a really nice one. It's Audrey Hepburn. Because, you know, Audrey Hepburn is bae. So it's Marilyn Monroe, let's be honest. But I can't find a Marilyn Monroe compact mirror that I like. All of the ones that they do that that has a Marilyn Monroe face on it, it's all like the pop art Marilyn Monroe, and I don't like that. I really prefer like the more natural portraits of Marilyn. I am in my room at 10 to 10 at night talking about the natural beauty of Marilyn Monroe. You'll notice that I've been doing a lot of quotes of her on Twitter recently. Wanna know why? Because she is bae. That is who she is. She is like, she is the ultimate woman. Like, you know, she's gorgeous. I hate to be the, you know, I hate that to be the first point, but she's gorgeous. You know, she went through a lot of her life with a mental illness, managed to become this icon with a mental illness, did not let it affect her too much. I mean, you know, she did have a lot of breakdowns on set, but we won't talk about that. She just kicked ass, basically. You know, people wonder why she's one of my inspirations. Oh, that's why. She didn't let anything stop her. She didn't let fear stop her. She just kept going. Going. What am I doing? Stop, Mel. Stop it. I'm hyper. I need to calm down because I'm going to bed in like 3 hours. I need to chill. Oh, there's politics tomorrow. Oh, I meant to tell you about Newsday, and I didn't. Yeah, so I was Bossman Bing for Friday's Newsday. Yeah, that was fun. I did really well, actually, apart from one douche ruining the day. Went all right. I did good bossing people around. I was like, you, what are you doing? You, give me an update. Tell me everything. I'm going to go because my nan's coming to bed. See you later.
The choice of media you consume tomorrow is going to have to be well selected and thought out. The choice of media you consume tomorrow is going to have to be well selected and thought out. There needs to be no romance in there whatsoever to suppress any potential triggered single bitterness. And you also still need to feel good. My recommendation is horror.
retreat tomorrow, like...
Oh no, would you look at that? It is totally empty again.
Yeah, just don't put my stuff in the locker. What, so you can give it to Jamie? Yeah, Jamie, what's that?
Look at all of the people here to see Jamie Dornan.
There's Jamie Dornan!
Let me down, Becky. I'm sorry.
I thought she was going to release it in a fangirl.
People are here.
It is okay.
It is not okay.
It is okay.
It's not okay.
It's always okay to love Jamie Dornan. Let's face it.
Okay, so welcome back to Groveling with Mal, the annual show in which I apologise for not uploading anything and beg for your forgiveness. Basically, I have been a giant piece of trash this month. In that I've either been too busy to record and upload anything, or just been a lazy piece of crap. It's mostly been the latter, but a couple of times I have had the first. So yeah, I want to apologise for that. Especially in comparison to January, when everything was so organised, there was an upload daily. So yeah, that I need to apologise for. But again, like January, nothing has happened this month. Wow. Valentine's Day was a couple of days ago. Which is fine. I like Valentine's Day. It's a nice day. It sucks being single on Valentine's Day. But I don't need to tell you that. You've seen the video. Is this my top? That is my top. So it's Sunday today, the 19th. I've got a politics lecture tomorrow. And then when I come home, I am going to film like crazy. I'll film Monday's vlog tomorrow, because that does not take long at all. I can bang a vlog out in about an hour. Not that I like doing that, of course, but there we go. So tonight I'll sit and write the script. Then tomorrow I will film, edit it up, and upload. And then, where is the... I was saying on news days, I wore this into uni. Is it just me? I mean, I know these are snow geese, but these look like really, really tiny versions, cartoon versions of male genitalia. Tomorrow when I get home, I am going to film like crazy. I'm going to film tomorrow's vlog, then Tuesday's gaming video. Not that I know what that is. I've got a timetable in my bullet journal downstairs, which I've not been sticking to. But yeah, hopefully... I'm not going to try and rectify my schedule too much, because hopefully I'll be able to pick it all back up properly in March. Yeah, I don't want to, you know, sit here and stand here really and be like, oh, I'm going to, from now on, I'm going to pick it up, because I know that for the rest of February, I'm not.
Ridiculous as it may seem to have to explain to a six-year-old child, but I do need your...
Go ahead.
I was expecting a very important special mail from my teacher, Professor Amelius Brown, and it hasn't come.
What's that going to do with my knob?
We'll learn it immediately and see if it has come. We may be able to do this
back to my old college. We're braving the weather because, you know, windy AF fam, Storm Doris, what are you playing at, love? So we can film this building. Basically, that's all we're here for. We're just filming this building. Basically, what's going on is we've been asked to do a TV, not TV package, we've been asked to do something on that building because it's getting restored. Restored.
I can't talk.
So we're trying to get builders to talk to us about the restoration. That's going so well, so very well, because no one wants to talk to us, which is fine.
We just stood here.
We are. We are literally
we're
just
sitting here staring at builders.
But yeah, we want to try and get a builder's perspective on the restoration, but nobody is coming out and nobody is willing to talk to us, and that's just red. That's just super red. Buried my bag. Just saying.
What's that mean?
February. It was a pretty calm month for the most part. Like January, I was faced with a lot of fears. And like January, it turns out that I was stupid for fearing those things, because in actual fact, they weren't as bad as I made them out to be in my head. Being in charge of a newsroom wasn't that daunting. It wasn't that scary. It was a little chaotic, and there were one or two people who ruined it a little bit. But for the most part, it was a pretty good day, and it was really fun being in charge of a newsroom. And yeah, I don't think I could do it as a full-time job. As fun as it was, every now and then taking charge is fine. But I think I am definitely more suited to anywhere but the newsroom. It was weird going back to my old college as well. We went inside to interview some of the staff members,
about the Priory, and it was weird walking down the corridor and going to the second refectory where I spent some of my time with my friends and looking up to the third floor where my classroom was. I think part of me hoped that I'd see some people because I still have friends who do the course there. So I think part of me hoped that I'd see somebody, but I went at the most awkward of times because either my friends were in their classes so they couldn't actually come out, or they just didn't have a class. Yeah, it was really weird. It did bring back a lot of memories. Yeah. It was interesting to see how much had changed as well, because last time I was there, the second refectory hadn't had this do-up, this glow-up, as it were. So there wasn't actually any colour to the atrium, but it was very colourful when I went. Again, very colourful. I think that everything that I have to say about February is that I did my best. Wasn't always recognised, but I did my best. And I think I did well. Obviously, there was a lot of room to improve, but it was good. I definitely need to stop overthinking. So anyway, that's all from me for now. Thanks for your time. Have a great day wherever you are, and I'll see you real soon. Bye!